built a lot of naval ships over the years. This was their first attempt at putting a fighter into the air, and they hit a bullseye with this airplane. Chauncey Vaught was the company, the owner of the company was Chauncey Vaught. Shortened his name to Chauncey. And you can see the airplane has got a bent wing. That's because the wings folded up on the deck of an aircraft carrier. And the wing was attached low to the fuselage so that the landing gear could be stubby and strong. And as short as possible without allowing the prop to hit the deck of an aircraft carrier, because carrier pilots will tell you they don't as much land on a carrier as they do a controlled crash. And too much tension on the long spindly landing gear would in fact break that gear. So the key to success was having it short and steady. To do that, you had to bend the wing down, but once the wing was coming up, the angle of the fuselage, you had to slide it back out parallel again. So that's the gull wing that they talked about. The enemy took great notice of this airplane. They called it, among other things, the bent wing bird. And they also called it the whistling death because of the sound that it made when it was on its attack line. Dan McCue is a former Delta Airlines captain. He's got over 35,000 hours of flight time to his credit, and he's going to bring this bent wing bird, this incredible Corsair. And Danny, you know, we talked, you think about this and how we've seen them most recently on that Baba Black Sheep television show. Got the wrong one, here it is.
We are poor little lambs who have lost our way.
He's been a warbird pilot and an airline pilot all of his adult life, very much at home in these warbirds. As he comes in over your left shoulder, you'll catch sight of that bend in the wing. That's also where, again, they could swivel over the top of the cockpit to get more of these aircraft below the deck of an aircraft carrier. The white protrusion on the wing down low is in fact a radar. Radar was brand new in World War II. It was the key to success with the weapon that was used later on as much as possible to detect the enemy first. As their frontline fighters well into the 50s. Look over your right shoulder. Dan McCue is going to bring it in on a stage scraping run as a tribute to Greg Cappy Boynton. There's the bent wing. There's the cockpit. In terms of rarity and cost, or have observed to protect our country and to preserve our freedom. Ladies and gentlemen, the United States Navy's tail hook legacy flight. What did they say about the warbirds of a past or a bygone era? The commemorative Air Force is one of the organizations that do that. The Yankee Air Force, the Warbirds of America, and the Canadian Warplane Heritage. Men and women, both women and civilians. And of course, the DOD, the Pentagon, 1997, about 25% of its maximum speed. Okay, look behind you now over the top of Hangar Row. As in that type of formation, the jet is trying very hard to stay as slow as it possibly can. And everybody believes the pistol car pulls shares out the ride, part of the fly, drive, ride for MS Research, will be returning to this field. The motorcycle polka run was organized and led by Rick Martin and the Saddlebacks Riding Club. Get this, folks, all proceeds from the polka run will benefit multiple sclerosis research. Please plug their t-shirts and such. Yes, they have t-shirts for sale. It is at the Fly Drive Ride for MS-10. And our thanks to those people. Their raffle will be at 2:30, and Bruce Turner says that our raffle